Well, it looks like the International Fellowship of Christians and Jews don't really like any kind of criticism, especially not when it's pointing out one of their CGI fake ads contains nothing more than special effects. Well, just for you listeners who love to hear this and love to spread this message on, here we go with the edited version. All of the copyright material that the IFCJ have used to take down the last video has been removed from this particular one here. And here it is, the recording of the phone call. Now, as this operator was warned that the phone call will be recorded, this is now my copyrighted material. Just for your pleasure, I present to you part one of the call to the IFCJ.
Thank you for calling the International Fellowship of Christians and Jews. Your call is important to us. Please stay on the line and your call will be answered by the next available agent.
Hello, this is Amy. Thank you for calling the International Fellowship of Christians and Jews. This call may be recorded for quality purposes. How are you doing today?
Fantastic, ma'am. Are you an agent for the Christian and Jews Alliance?
Oh, yes. So how may I help you, sir?
Well, I've got $1,000 I'd like to give to your cause. I saw an ad earlier today on my TV, and I am outraged. I am incensed. I am totally beside myself as much as... How can these people do this to the poor people of Israel?
Right, I understand. A lot of people share the same sentiment. So, sir, with regard to your concern, can I get your name and address so we can send you more information on how you can stand with Israel?
Well, first of all, ma'am, I'm referring to the advertisement I saw, and they say that there's thousands of rockets being fired every single day. Is that correct?
That is true, sir. That is true.
Thousands of rockets a day?
Yes.
So how many people have died since 2000 to 2008? Can you tell me?
Well, sir, I'm not provided with that information, but a lot of people have...
Well, 1,000 rockets a day, there would be... hundreds of thousands every year dying? So from 2000 to 2008, we're talking about at least 800,000 people dying? Is that right?
Well,
wow.
I can't confirm the figure, but a lot of people really are caught in between the crossfire, sir.
Well, if there's thousands of people dying every day, I'd like to see the names and the list of these people, because oy vey, I would like to give them money to help these people rebuild Israel.
Yes, actually that is one of the reasons why we have posted that advertisement, so we can encourage people to help out in this cause.
Fantastic. It's great to see people doing things to help people in need. I mean, it's not like Israel have got a lot of money. After all, in 2007, America gave $6.8 million a day to Israelis. Yeah, I mean, that's not a lot of money. They need more, right?
Mm-hmm. Correct. Actually, it's... Your help would be very much appreciated. Because
absolutely. We got to stop these Arabs from having their freedom, from having their lives. You know, we got to take that away from them, because when they got their lives, they've got too much.
Right, that is true.
You know something, ma'am? In fact, between 2000 and 2008, from the research I've been doing, I found 18 people have died from these rocket attacks. 18.
The figure you were able to get.
Well, that's available on the internet, ma'am. That's not any conspiracy theory I'm trying to dig up here. In fact, in the same time frame from 2000 to 2008, 458 people have died from peanut allergies. That's 24 times the amount that have died from Hamas rockets from Palestine. And in fact, these rockets are being fired into Israeli-occupied territories that used to be owned by Palestinians. And you support that?
Well, with regard to that, I really am, I'm not allowed to give out my political views.
I'm not asking you for your political stance. I'm not asking you what they teach you there, but you are brain damaged enough to believe that you're doing something for the people of Israel by genociding the Palestinian people? Honestly, think about it. Just for a moment, if not for yourself, for the human beings that you are supplying bullets for. You're supplying bullets to shoot children in the head. How do you feel as a Christian about that?
I've learned about that. And
does your God allow that? Does your God allow that, ma'am?
First of all, I'm a Christian, sir. So.
And Christianity allows people to go and shoot kids in the head?
Of course.
Really?
It's not allowed, yes.
It is allowed according to Judaism, according to the Israelis, according to the IDF and the rabbis who are giving out the hate speech to these people who, before they go into Gaza, to go and shoot these children. They're being they're being tutored by the rabbis to go and do that, by Israeli IDF rabbis. We have the evidence on that, ma'am. And that is quite okay with you people, because you're collecting money to support this. You're supporting this. You're allowing this to happen. You're actually collecting money to allow children to be shot in the head. I hope your God is happy. I hope you're happy. I hope you sleep at night, ma'am.
Hello, sir?
I'm right here.
Yes, and providing economic assistance, we actually work with municipalities to identify the families most in need of a helping hand. Whether they're Jews, Christians, or Arab, we are not able to provide assistance directly to the areas controlled by the Palestinian Authority due to security reasons.
Well, security reasons, how about you start bombing the peanut factories? Because 24 times many people die from peanut allergies than die from Hamas rockets. Do you realize what your advertisement is telling people? Well, your advertisement, by the way, contains an interesting amount of CGI special effects. You know, in the terms of video industry, that is called fake. Did you know that?
Well, I haven't really seen the complete advertising.
You haven't even seen the advertising, yet you're taking money off people for this advertisement? That is called misleading advertisement. You know you can be sued for that? Especially if you're working for a company that is putting out false advertising, misleading people. Do you realize you could be held legitimate, you could be held liable yourself personally? I wonder if God has a lawyer. Does your God have a lawyer? Does he have a good number?
Well, sir, for that, if you want to know more about that, we have a website you may go to.
Really? So these people can actually be contacted so that a class action suit can be launched against them? Please, ma'am, what's that number? What is that website?
The website is www.ifcj, that's the letters I.
IFCJ?
Like Frank, yes, C like at, J like
wow. Okay, well, my lawyer will be definitely glad to receive that. Amen. Hallelujah. And you call yourself a Christian. Gee, I wonder what Jesus would have thought, because Jesus was a Palestinian. I wonder if you know that actually spoke Aramaic. Did you know that, ma'am?
Yes, I do.
And that's quite okay for you, for the Israelis to take land off Jesus' people and to shoot them, like with 20 times as many rockets, as 20 times as many depleted uranium bombshells. That's quite okay with you, because, what, they were Jesus' people, and they don't deserve the land? Is that what your feeling is?
Well, sir, so I really don't have any, you know, stand on that.
Well, you don't have any opinion because you're being brainwashed. Obviously, you're there for just good looks and say, hello, sir, how can I take your money?
Oh, no, sir. It's actually, you have a lot of ways that you can stand with Israel, not just financial donations.
Well, let's face it. Who would want to stand with a nation that was born of violence and is ruled by a gun and is ruled by the missile and the Apache helicopter? Who would want to stand with that? And you call yourself religious? How dare you? One of the commandments of God is thou shalt not kill. Have you never heard of that? Have you not heard of that?
The what, sir?
Thou shalt not kill. It's one of the commandments. You've not heard of that?
I've heard of that, sir.
Incredible. Incredible. And yet you still support Israel. They are breaking God's commandments. In fact, the people who are actually in control of the army that's moving in to occupy Palestine are actually Ashkenazis. They're known as atheists. They don't actually believe in a God. And you're supporting non-committal atheists. You're supporting Ashkenazis. Did you know that, ma'am? Are you aware of the people who you are actually supporting? Israel are not a religious nation. They're based on an atheism. Ashkenazis don't have a God. They don't have a religion. They don't believe in the God of Abraham. These are the people in control of the Knesset. In fact, most of them have families from Europe. They're not even born there. They're not holy people. They want to see just death and destruction. They want to see as many possible casualties as they can possibly find. And you support that? And you call yourself a Christian?
Now, for this one, sir, actually, we really don't do that. What we do is we just help out the people caught in the crossfire, whether they're Jews, Christians, or Arabs.
Click on part 2 to finish this video.